After that, the United Nations were established with the promise to bring about peace, security, and the realization of human rights, which in fact meant a global management. One can analyze the current system of governance of world affairs by examining three events. The first is the event of the 11 September 2001, which has indeed affected the entire world for almost a decade. We recall that at the time, suddenly the news of an attack on the Twin Towers was broadcast. Using numerous footages of the incident, almost all governments and known figures that mattered strongly condemned this incident. But then a propaganda machine came into full force. It was implied that the whole world was now exposed to a huge danger, namely that of terrorism, and that the only way to save the world would be to deploy forces into Afghanistan. Eventually, Afghanistan and shortly thereafter Iraq were occupied. Now please take note. It was said that some 3,000 people were killed on September 11, for which we are all very saddened. Yet, up until now, in Afghanistan and Iraq, hundreds of thousands of people have been killed, millions wounded and displaced, and the conflict is still going on and expanding. In identifying those responsible behind the September 11 attacks, there were three viewpoints. First, that a very powerful and complex terrorist group, able to successfully cross all layers of the American intelligence and security, carried out the attack. This is the prevalent viewpoint, which has been supported mainly and advocated by American statesmen. Second, that some segments within the U.S. government orchestrated the attack to reverse the declining American economy and its grips on the Middle East in order to save the Zionist regime. The majority of the American people, as well as most nations and politicians around the world, agree with this view. Third, it was carried out by a terrorist group, but that the American government supported and took advantage of the situation. Apparently, this viewpoint has fewer proponents. The main evidence for this viewpoint links the incident with a few passports found in the huge volume of rubble, and a video of an individual whose place of domicile was unknown, but it was announced that he had been involved in oil deals with some American officials. It was also covered up and said that due to the explosion and fire, no trace of suicide attackers was found. Regardless of each of these three viewpoints, there remain a few questions to be answered. First, would it not have been sensible that first a thorough investigation should have been conducted by independent groups to conclusively identify the elements involved in the attack and then map out a rational plan to take measures against them? Second, assuming the viewpoint of the American government, is it rational to launch a classic war through widespread deployment of troops that led to the death of hundreds of thousands of people to counter a terrorist group? Third, was it not possible to act the way Iran conducted the Rigi operations, fighting the Rigi terrorist group who killed and wounded 400 innocent people? In the Iranian operation, no innocent person was harmed. It is proposed that the United Nations set up an independent fact-finding group for the event of September 11, so that in the future expressing views about it, to ensure that the different views about it are not banned from discussion in the future. Announced clearly that the occupation of other countries under the pretext of freedom and democracy is an unforgivable crime. The world needs the logic of compassion and justice and inclusive participation instead of the logic of force, domination, unilateralism, war, and humiliation.